miracle. I want to know, are you ready?
Why do we insist on... A lot of people are really doing the best they can to stay bound in tradition. But it's man's tradition, not that of the Father. And there is such an ecstatic move of God. That cannot be stopped. It cannot be quenched. And we will not shut up. We will continue to preach Christ until the day I die. And even then, they can watch my videos. Seriously, we get emails and that all the time. When are you going to start preaching something deep? What, deeper than Christ? How deep do you want? And a lot of people are out there chasing the greater revelation. I know people, according to what their little mind has said, they have their own unicorn. God gave them a unicorn. Isn't that lovely? I said, you sure it's not just a skinny rhinoceros? And they're like, no, it's a spiritual unicorn. I'm like, yes. Yes. Up your medication. And they're like, God's given me my own planet, and I fly up there with my dragon. I'm like, you watched that, what was that movie? With the never-ending story. And been, a little too much, methinks. Quit making stuff up. People that scare me the most are the people that keep talking about the book of Revelation. I'm like, no one's figured it out, so just sit down and shut up. Enjoy Christ. Don't worry about the rest. Doesn't matter what happens. We'll be that drunk. I don't care if there's zombies walking around. We've had a few in here. Offer them a cookie. Are you ready? Are you ready? Has the goods. We've got all power, all authority. We can heal, cleanse, raise, set free. We can get them drunk in the Holy Ghost, which is better than any drug out there. If you're on drugs and you're listening to this, or you've got a problem with substance abuse, come here. I will lay hands on you and you will get higher than you've ever been in your entire life. It will be the buzz that will kill that buzz that's penetrated and destroying your life. I don't care if you've been on stuff that's destroyed your teeth, that's destroyed your insides. I know the God in me that when I lay my hands on you, you'll get a whole new set of and he'll set you free from that addiction. You'll be walking around. What happened to you? Oh, I went to church and it was wonderful. Oh, you can't be drunk all the time. That's not godly. He invented it. It's part of the Holy Ghost job description. He's the comforter. He's here. It's so cloudy in here. Hey, young people and older people have turned to substances which are counterfeit to the presence of God. In the presence of God is fullness of, Shibi Baba, is the fullness of joy and is peace and love and joy forevermore. Out of his presence is misery, heartache, torment, sickness, disease, death and decay. We got a choice. death and decay, ravaged by drugs, or life in the Holy Spirit. Well, we had some complaints already about this morning's meeting. You guys are just a little bit too free, I'm afraid. Gotta cut back on some of that freedom. Your freedom is offending people. I got rebuked for my preaching. After I'd already explained the difference between being sober-minded and drunk in the spirit, you can always spot a religious devil. They quote the Bible at you. You get them to lay hands on somebody and do a miracle, they can't do it. But they can quote some scripture at you and get into an argument. You don't get into a religious debate. Phew! All right. How are we going? All right. Drunk you are. Use the force you will. Oh, happy days. Goodbye, gray sky. Hello, blue. Look out, religious spirit, we're coming after you. They just don't bother coming to my meetings anymore. Which is a shame, because they're good fun to tease. No, I won't shoo. You shoo. Who shoo? Yeshua HaMashiach. Phew. Phew. I feel like I'm jumping out of my skin. I'm not, but I feel like I am. All right. Oh, Jesus. Phew. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands, bom, bom. If you're happy and you know it, then you really ought to show it. All right, I better read some Bible. Oh, I've read some Bible. That's what got us drunk in the first place.
Destroy the devil's plan. Heal the leper, fed 5,000 with just one command. He said, he who has ears, let him hear.
Jesus, help me. Make my job difficult by turning up. Most preachers just get up, waffle on. Don't have to worry about God turning up. He doesn't even like them. I'm not rocking up there. They got timbrels and flags. I'm not going to that church. Keep waving them at me. What do they think? Yahoo, we're down here, Jesus. Look for the big red flag with fire written on it. Oh, help. First time here, sitting in front row, very brave.